Welcome to my kitchen where I will be testing out my early Christmas present. I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's first unpack this meat grinder. This has 3000 watts of peak output power and 800 watts of rated power. It grinds 2 pounds of meat per minute. It features a big capacity and detachable tray, a stainless steel wrapped body, full metal gearbox and metal gears, and an all food grade materials parts. This has overheat protection, which protects your machine and thus extends the life of your meat grinder, and features an upgraded three-stage extrusion technology, which prevents stiff meat fiber from being destroyed. Besides making ground meat, you can also use this to make different kinds of sausages. This includes three stainless steel cutting plates with coarse, medium, and fine grinding of meat. What I will be using today is the coarser one because that is the consistency I like to make meatballs with. There are also three sizes of sausage stuffer tubes along with the adapter. You can prepare meat pies, burgers, meatballs, sausages, and more with this. What you aren't seeing is in the background, I am quickly washing this by hand. Not the motor part, just all the accessories need to be washed before use, and you can't use the dishwasher. This is not dishwasher safe. You can also not let it air dry. It has to be dried by hand with a soft cloth. Because this is not something that you will be using every single day, that shouldn't be a problem. For me, it's not. This was so easy to put together. There you can see me trying it out for the first time with no issues whatsoever. One of the first things I noticed is that it has a reverse button. The reverse button is for when things do get stuck. Sometimes depending on the quality of meat that you're using, you may have a problem and you need to reverse and back the meat up. That didn't happen to me today, but you do have a function to reverse the meat. It has non-slip feet. When I tried to pick this up, it stuck pretty well to my countertop. I like that it firmly stays in place, although it doesn't have a lot of vibration, and it is also not as noisy as I expected it to be. What I noticed is that it grinds very fast when I'm pushing down on the meat, but even when I'm just adding meat to the grinder, it was still pretty fast. I feel it's important for you to know that this part has not been sped up. The speed that you're seeing it grind here is in real time, and I was very impressed with it. At this point, I decided to put the meat through the grinder a second time just to mix the fat and the beef a bit better. It also gave me the perfect consistency that I was looking for. Here you can see it after the first time, and I will show you after the second time in a few seconds. There you go. Now it is ready to form into balls, and I'm going to be taking it apart again now to see how easy it is. That wasn't quite the right angle. Let's try from the other side. I may have fastened it just a little bit too much. There we go. And I'm pulling it all out again. There is a bit of meat stuck on the inside still, but that wasn't a problem. I just added it to the ground meat that I've made for today's dinner. I had to wash it again afterwards. It took a few minutes, and I'm impressed with this. I think that this is going to serve us for many years. It is great quality. Actually, a lot better than we expected. And because we are hunting, this will see quite a bit of venison. I'm looking forward to be using this for a long time to come. I highly recommend this. Thank you so much for watching today. Bye bye.